So today I'm going to talk about the potential complications of having your gallbladder removed. There's definitely a train of thought where we don't really need our gallbladder, so there's not going to be any complications. But over 700,000 surgeries are done every single year, and 40% of the people who have their gallbladder removed have complications. So I'm going to be talking about that. The medical term for this is post-cholecystectomy syndrome. So before I go into the symptoms, I want to talk about why someone would experience those symptoms. It really has to do with bile. So bile is made by your liver, and bile drains down through a tube or a duct, and it gets stored in the gallbladder. When you eat, you need less of the bile to digest food because it's very concentrated. So without a gallbladder, all you have now is a tube from your liver to the small intestines, and it trickles, but it's not concentrated. So typically the complications from not having a gallbladder have to do with a lack of bile. But there's exceptions to that. Sometimes there's a situation where we have too much bile going into the small intestine, in which case you have to take a certain medication to block the production of bile. So that's a different situation. What I want to talk about is the symptoms that occur with not enough bile. Now, a good analogy to help you understand what bile is, it is soap or a detergent, okay? Now, detergent is very interesting because it is both water-soluble and fat-soluble. In other words, you can put it on fat, like greasy hands, and rub it all around, and it will break down the fat, and so it's more water-soluble. So you can wash your hands, and it can actually go down the drain, right? So this is oil, and this is detergent. So I'll show you what happens as an analogy to what happens when you release bile. So we're going to take this detergent and we're going to pour it into the oil. Now, at the molecular structure of a detergent, you have one part that loves water and one part that loves oil or lipids or fat. So when I pour this into the oil, okay, put a little bit in there, and then I seal it up. Like this. Okay, so now just keep watching. So as you can see, the detergent broke down the oil or fat into smaller particles, and that's what bile does. So it's another word for that is emulsification, okay? So you can see it's in a state now where you could literally pour this down the drain and it won't clog anything because now it's more water soluble. Your bile will break down fat into small particles to allow the pancreas to release an enzyme called lipase and to make it easy to digest that to even a smaller particle where you can absorb it in your intestine. So if you are deficient in bile salts, you're going to have difficulty digesting fats. So you may experience bloating, indigestion, gas, burping. Okay, so that's number one. Number two, constipation. One of the functions of bile is to help lubricate the colon. And without bile, you may have constipation. But if you have too much bile, because maybe there's the duct is too large or the opening is too large, you can get the opposite, diarrhea. If you have diarrhea, you don't want to take more bile, okay, even as a supplement, because that's going to make it worse. Okay, we mentioned gas, bloating, even stomach pain, okay. You can even experience your skin becoming more yellow or your eyes becoming yellow. That's jaundice. One of the purposes of the bile is to take the byproduct of red blood cells, which is bilirubin, and help you eliminate it through the body. So if there's some type of blockage going on in the liver where you're getting a backup of bilirubin, that can come out through the skin and create this situation right here. And usually what this means is that you need more bile to help remove the obstruction and allow the drainage. Bile will actually stimulate your own release or flow of bile through the ducts, especially if there's sludge or a gallstone sitting in there, because bile will help to dissolve it. One of the causes of a gallstone is concentrated cholesterol, because there's not enough bile to keep it broken down. All right, hypothyroidism. Your body has certain enzymes that convert T4, the inactive version of the thyroid hormone, to T3, the active form of the thyroid hormone. Well, guess what? Bile triggers that conversion. So without enough bile, it can create hypothyroid symptoms. Number 9, your right shoulder is very, very tight. If there's congestion or some type of blockage of the ducts from your liver, so you can't release the bile, it backs up and causes pressure irritation, and it can create referral pain in your right shoulder, up to your neck, even headaches on this side. It can also leave you with a tightness underneath your right rib cage. The solution is to take some purified bile salts, because it will help remove the obstruction and open the flow so you have less pressure in that area. Dry skin, dry eyes. This is a vitamin A deficiency. Because bile helps you break down and absorb vitamin A, D, E, or K, a deficiency of bile could give you symptoms of vitamin A, E, D, or K. And then we have vision problems. A certain percent of the population notice that their eyes are blurry after they have their gallbladder removed, or they have vision issues, or they may have glaucoma, or a problem even with cataracts. You need vitamin A to prevent those conditions. So without enough vitamin A, you may have a difficult time seeing, especially in the dark at night, and that lack of vitamin A can create a whole series of issues. So for all of these complications, purified bile salts, you can take one or two after a meal. If you want to see some quick results, sometimes if you have like right shoulder pain or tightness underneath the right rib cage, you can take one on an empty stomach and take another one on an empty stomach later in the day. And that will give your liver a chance to drain properly and get rid of that sensation. All right, thanks for watching. Before you go real quick, I have a course entitled How to Bulletproof Your Immune System. It's a free course. I want you to take it. And here's why. Here's you. Here is your environment. Everyone is focused on this over here, avoiding your environment. But what about here? What about strengthening your immune system? That's what's missing. This course will show you how to bulletproof yourself, and so you can tolerate and resist your environment much better by strengthening your own immune system. I put a link down in the description right down below. Check it out and get signed up today. Hey, before